That fiberglass or cellulose that you have in your home is a lot dirtier than you think it is. Now, if you suffer from allergies or asthma, or you just want to have a healthy home in general, you're going to want clean insulation, and I'm going to show you exactly how dirty that insulation is. Now, if I'm dressed like this and I've got this bad boy ready, you know we're about to have some fun. Safety first. Before you start messing with that old insulation, you're going to want to make sure that you are completely covered and protected. So as you can see here, I am completely suited up and I have a nice pair of gloves and a respirator. This is because I don't want to breathe in any of the dust from the cellulose, and specifically, anytime that you work with fiberglass, you should have coverings like this because it is made of fine little fibers of glass. That glass can embed in your skin, it can get in your eyes, and you can even inhale it and embed it in your lungs. So if you're going to be handling fiberglass, make sure that you're completely covered like I am to make sure that you're safe and you don't come in contact with those particles. So why does traditional insulation get so gross? Fiberglass and cellulose both trap allergens like pollen, dust, and pet dander, making them a breeding ground for airborne irritants. Thing is, too, is that if you kick up that cellulose, all of those irritants are going to get into your house through the vents and things like that. Another thing to keep in mind is that moisture easily gets into these materials, especially in crawl spaces and attics, which creates a perfect environment for mold and mildew to grow. Cellulose and fiberglass, they don't stop airflow, so outside pollutants can move freely through your walls and into your living space. Now, they might slow it down, but they do not completely stop it, and that's something you have to keep in mind. The way that these materials are made, they still allow for the air to move through them, which means all of those pollutants are kind of stuck inside of it, so it doesn't really go away. Another reason why the insulation is so gross is that critters love traditional insulation, unfortunately. So mice, squirrels, bats, and bugs all love to nest in fiberglass and cellulose. As you can see here, it's really easy to pull apart and turn into little critter condos that are nice and cozy, but where they sleep, they probably also poop. So these pests leave behind droppings in urine, which can trigger allergies, spread bacteria, and even cause serious diseases. There are lots of rodent droppings here that have embedded into the fiberglass. So if you want a healthy home, that's something that you need to keep in mind. If you have a rodent infestation, that can lead to thousands of droppings in a short amount of time, turning your attic into a toxic mess. Once those pests are gone, that contaminated insulation has to be removed carefully to avoid exposure and also following CDC guidelines for cleanup. Moisture plus fiberglass equals mold, which doesn't just affect the air quality, it can also rot wood and damage your home's structure. Now, if you see here on this piece of fiberglass, you can see that there is actually the formation of mold starting, and that can be very dangerous. Fiberglass and cellulose will retain moisture, and that moisture is pushed right against the framing of your home. That can lead to damage, which can be costly repairs. So now you're probably asking, can I be allergic to insulation? Technically, yeah, because like I said, the fiberglass and the cellulose, they are going to retain any of those pollutants and allergens and the things that the traditional insulation is made up from. Cellulose is actually made from recycled newspaper, so inherently it is very dusty. All of that dust, like I said, it can get into your vents, circulate throughout your home, and that can cause you to have an allergic reaction to the dust or kick up your asthma symptoms. So why do you have to remove this old stuff? Specifically, we're going to talk about the attic and the crawl space first. Now, in those situations, you have to remove that old insulation because it's going to block the performance of the spray foam. One, the spray foam needs to have a clean space to adhere to. The old insulation in your attic, once you have that spray foam, you don't really need it anymore, and it hinders the airflow that you want to create in the space. Same thing is true for your crawl space. Now, let's talk about those walls. When it comes to RetroFoam, you don't have to remove anything because RetroFoam compresses it so much that it completely fills the cavity, and you don't have to worry about air moving through it to cause those issues like allergies and asthma attacks. RetroFoam and spray foam insulation both create an air seal. That air seal, sealing your entire building envelope, is going to help make your home be more healthy. Real quick, let's just hit those benefits of spray foam insulation and RetroFoam. It's going to create an air seal, which means no more air movement through your home from allergens and pollutants from outside making their way in. It's also going to help deter pests. Now, spray foam insulation and RetroFoam specifically don't contain any materials or chemicals that deter pests, but what it does do is it creates that air seal, and that air leakage is what pests look for to get inside of your home. So if you're filling all of those cracks and crevices, They don't know how to get inside. Creating an air seal in your home also helps to prevent any kind of moisture or mold issues that you're going to deal with if you have traditional insulation. Because it doesn't promote mold growth and it doesn't retain moisture, that's something that you're not going to have to worry about. And finally, foam insulation is going to help you create a healthier home. Because those allergens and pollutants aren't coming into your house, things will be healthier. And the bonus of that is that foam insulation's air seal is also going to help make your home more energy efficient. Now that I've gotten uncomfortably close to some rodent poop and showed you exactly how dirty this insulation is, you might be ready to make a change to make your home healthier. Now, if that's the case, check out the dealer finder on our website. There you're going to find RetroFoam dealers across the country and hopefully one in your neck of the woods. I'm your somewhat filthy building science Brainiac, reminding you to bring a little science to every project.